Hi guys, so this is me, yeah, the man the man behind this channel. Really sorry for being so inactive for the past few months. I was really burned out, to be honest. Anyway, let's start. Kairi Gusion. I was curious because, you know, he's really a good assassin player, and seeing him use Gusion just quite unexpected, because I usually expect him to use Lanceling and Fanny. Anyways, without further ado, let's start the game.
Me please, Albert. Can you please help? Yes. Thank you, Brody. Do you wanna die? Bye bye.
Yeah, honestly, the first dagger was kind of unnecessary. He could just ignore Mincy and proceed to Lito.
What is Paquito, bro?
I don't know if you guys saw my tutorial, but whenever you go to red jungle, you could just throw the first dagger, the first skill, your dagger to the red buff, or vice versa. You can also try to start with the red buff and throw your dagger to the monster, little monster. And when they're about to get close, you can just click again your first skill to get at the back of one of the jungle monster. Yeah, I create a video for that. You can just see it so that you guys can see how I farm efficiently with Gusion.
Oh my god, I think point is coming to me, guys. Can you please stand time, bro?
Okay, so majority of Gusion player will really burst this player. They are going to use the third skill near the enemy hero rather than far from the enemy hero, so that the damage output would be high. But Kairi here, what he did is, instead of bursting near Mincy, he tried to use his third skill away from Mincy. Honestly, this is a wise move, because considering the HP left, I think that's below about 30% only HP, so throwing dagger that is far from him and then clicking the second combo back to Mincy will definitely kill him instantly. So you guys who are aspiring to be a Gusion player, always be mindful and be tactic on using your skills. Yeah.
Ada pelikan gak? Oh my god, ada. I thought ada bang, sorry. I think they were turtle, buddy. Oh no, they don't.
I don't know why, but if I were in his position in this game, the turtle is already up. I would rather save my skills here and then gather with the team to the turtle, because, you know guys, when you play rank, I know Kairi already know this, but maybe he's just trying to enjoy the game. If you guys are especially in a higher tier rank, objective will always be better than solo kill, so do not try to waste your skills and HP to unnecessary kills.
Turtle, okay, nice. Ayo ba, push mob. Tay banying, ayo. In the TV. Oh my god, Stohan anying. Sorry guys, Stohan. Not like Albert Pasheng. Sorry, okay.
Not like Albert Pasheng.
My goodness, everyone is in the top, eh?
definitely those flash in the top is kind of unnecessary for a team fight.
What the fuck? Oh my god, fuck, can you help me please? Look at me please, fuck man! Kosong.
Yeah, that's the only cons about Gusion. When you don't have your third skill, it's over. Like, once the enemy reaches close to you, you don't have any escape, and you don't have, especially Kairi and his situation there, all are being used to the gold, to the crab. So I think what we could learn from this situation, guys, for those aspiring Gusion players, is that never ever try to get a crab when, especially when the enemy core is missing, because high chance that the enemy core is waiting for you to use all your skills to the monster or to the crab, and then he will just steal it from you and kill you also. So it's a bonus crab and a bonus skill.
Where is okay. Paquito? Where are you, baby Paquito? Are you in my blue buff? I think no.
I like how he used
oh, shit,
the
map. And there is Misitar, bro, in the top lane. Woy, bob, anjing! Toxic, anjing! Memek, I knew it, brother! Edit.
That was so that's a waste. But he could actually kill that if only the dog first kill hit.
Oh my god. Hey, long. Kenapa you hit the script, anjing?
That was actually a good idea. Like, when you guys encountered Paquito, do not ever try to dive him inside the tower. I swear, I've been there as a Gusion main. A lot of Paquito core can usually outplay inside a tower.
Script, anjing. Udote bang, missing?
No.
Okay. 12 bang, 12 bros. 10 lang, 10.
Namin dyan.
Kaya lang, tarik. I'm not sakit, anjing. Kaya lang, wait ya. Step lang, step lang. My god, not die. Oh my god, I'm dead. Please, please help me, please. Oh my god! Thank you, Lord. Oh my god, so keren.
So his first and second item is Arcane Boots and Genius Wand. Yeah, that's actually early damage output items for Gusion. You should always start with Arcane and Genius Wand. As much as possible, you have to end the game early. So that is why it is a smart buy if you start with Arcane Boots and Genius Wand.
Kanta terbang, boleh nggak bang, please?
Oh, is he gonna use Clock of Destiny? I'm not a fan of that, to be honest. Like, if you are using Gusion, your goal is to end the game as fast as possible. Well, again, this is just a casual game for Kairi, and he has good teammates here. So, if you guys are playing solo, Gusion as much as possible. Go for the early to mid game items that will end the game early.
Oh my god, Gusion KOF so good, guys! I love you, Gusion!
I honestly totally agree with him. This is so far the best skin of Gusion. His map awareness is really, really good. Like, the way he moves his map is just on the next level.
What the fuck, where's the pakita, Nying?
Emi baru saja memberikan 25,000.
What the fuck? Pakito, why are you always farming, bro? Help your friends, please. Your friends, everyone already died, you don't want to show. Oh my god. Who's the boss? Kasi tau, Bob! Oh my god, you have 14, nice try. So, Pakito want his teman mati guys semua before dia, dia fight.
I do understand that in that situation he was waiting for enemy to gank, but if I were in his position on this game again and again, I know he's not taking this game really seriously, but start pushing the mid. Like, if you guys can see that the bot and top minions, it's already almost on the enemy next turret, so which is why if I were in his position, I would just push the mid before taking the buff or ganking.
Keras bang.
See, if only he pushed it earlier, Parsa would still be on top, in top, and he's the your team is already pushing on the mid, or I mean you are already pushing the mid.
Hello, Minsitar. Oh god, Minsit.
No, everyone's. See, all enemies now in the mid because they have done defending the bottom. Farsa is done defending top. So, yeah, you know. That's the thought on how to push. Guys, do not push only on one lane. As much as possible, you have to synchronize all lanes so that only a few is defending one turret at a time.
Over tinkers. Oi, look at bang. I wait pakita ning. Pakito. What are you doing, yo? You think you can kill me? No, you cannot kill me forever.
That's actually so good. Yeah?
Bye-bye.
That is good.
Keren ka, guys? Oh, I thought. Oh my god, so.
That's
so slow, that, guys, sorry!
That's so confusing.
My god.
It was unnecessary, you know. Now, see, after the enemy was smart, they know Gusion used all his skills and now they tried to start to clash. They tried to start a clash. Now, Kairi cannot do anything at this point because he has no third skill. Yeah, can't do anything.
Misi dan masih ada ulti bro.
That's so good. Hey.
Ah.
Nice fast speech.
Ah, I need to type.
Everyone should learn how to fast switch. If you guys are trying to become a Gusion main, that's one of the basic things you have to master: fast switch items.
Alright, guys, wait.
Victory. So yeah, that's it. Not so much for our reaction, but yeah, what I can say is it's not totally that fast hand for in Gusion, but. Yeah, I can see that it's not his main and there are a lot of things he could do better with those skills. He thrown with those daggers and first skill, second skill. There are combos he haven't utilized, but it doesn't matter because he has a good team and they're winning. But at some point, if you guys want to utilize and maximize Gusion, you have to be very, very careful and mindful when to use your skills because we don't not have any purpose. We are not durable. We are not based on basic attacks. We're not marksman. We don't have support skills. Totally garbage whenever all skills are on cooldown. So I think that's it. Yeah, see you in the next bit, guys.